Oh God, they ruined it. They actually managed to screw up Spider-Man in the Avengers game, and I am so freaking annoyed about this. What's up, gamers? Dreamcastguy here, and as many of my subscribers know, I'm completely obsessed with Spider-Man. I think he's debatably the greatest superhero of all time. That's why I customize every single piece of freaking gear I get to have Spider-Man logos on it. I'm always doing stuff like playing through the Spider-Man games and reading the Spider-Man comics. I think that he's such a fantastic mix of brains and brawn. I mean, he's somebody that I feel like has pretty much unlimited potential. The fact that they decided to do the stupidest, laziest DLC. Let me try and calm down. Let's back up a bit. We're about to get the next chapter of downloadable content coming to the Avengers game. Now, in general, the Avengers game by Square Enix kinda sucks. It's got a lot of stupid microtransactions. They constantly try and sell you multiple battle passes, and a lot of the storylines themselves are just pretty basic. The main reason people were even playing this completely broken, crappy game is mostly because of the superheroes in it. Like, it was a great chance to play as Thor and Iron Man and Hulk and kind of just smash stuff up. Well, they kept teasing the fact that more heroes were going to come, and over the course of last year, we finally got stuff like Hawkeye coming to the game, and of course the gigantic War for Wakanda Black Panther expansion. But we all knew that eventually, Spider-Man had to come to the game. Well, he's finally coming out. Today they finally showed us some first actual gameplay of it. Now we're going to look at some GIFs of it, because honestly, freaking IGN loves to try and copyright strike stuff, and I don't want this video taken down. This is the gameplay that they released this morning. Now, as you'll notice, Spider-Man is air-punching stuff. Spider-Man seems to be pretty bad at actually landing a hit itself. Now, I've got another great video of it here. Look at this. This is Spider-Man fighting off freaking people in power suits, and it looks like he's ghost-punching the air to shoot out different projectiles. Look at these people just dying around him. Now, I'll be honest, I would be much more forgiving about this terrible-looking gameplay if we knew that there was going to be an actual story in it. But with this reveal of these first gameplay teases, they also announced officially that there is going to be no story missions. There's no plot. The Avengers game, which just plays like trash, is a complete dumpster fire. They're releasing the best hero ever with the worst gameplay, and he doesn't even get his own plotline. What it spells out here is that basically that since we know the fact that Spider-Man is only coming to the PlayStation 4 and PlayStation 5 versions of the game, it seems as if they decided to do this as the cheapest way possible. What he has instead of an operation event, which is what the other people had, he has a hero event. This has a short setup cutscene where you see Spider-Man kind of chilling with people. This is it. This is the entire Spider-Man story. You're putting him into an official Avengers game in 2021, and it's just a picture of him sitting on the couch playing video games. I mean, this is so lazy. It is so pathetic. But wait, it somehow manages to get worse. So in this little gameplay thing that IGN put out, I can't believe this is actually on the trending tab. You can see that it has a lot of dislikes already. So please like this video and subscribe if you haven't already. The part of this that aggravates me the most is the fact that this has the glass ceiling system of web swinging. So essentially, whenever you're playing as Spider-Man, you of course have to do some traversal. This is a big town. It's got some big missions, but a lot of the Avengers game takes place in gigantic deserts or empty spaces. So they just decided to make it where Spider-Man swings off of the air. Like, straight up, Spider-Man, like, let me show you some clips of this. So right there, he's grabbing onto an actual light post. That's pretty cool. But when there's nothing around, Spider-Man just grabs onto the sky, because they just don't care. This IGN employee actually mentions the fact that this gameplay we see during the course of this like preview they got to do was not their gameplay. This isn't the person who's doing the voiceover actually playing it. They were only allowed to show clips approved by Square Enix, and this is still the best they could do, is times where clearly Spider-Man is grabbing onto just, what is he grabbing? Uncle Ben's ghost? Straight up, What annoys me about this is that I like a bunch of different styles of Spider-Man game, but what's ridiculous about this is that we're now getting the worst version of him in the Avengers game. Now, this seems like just such an obviously terrible choice, because why would you release the worst version of Spider-Man onto the PlayStation 4 and PlayStation 5 when that has, well, in my opinion, the very best Spider-Man ever? Like, straight up, Spider-Man on PlayStation 4 and Miles Morales on PlayStation 5, these are the best of the best. I was even just randomly playing it again this morning for funsies, and while swinging around and stuff, the physics, the graphics, the lighting, the care to detail, this is the best that Spider-Man will probably ever be. And on top of that, of course, it had an actual story in it. The fact that they decided to do the laziest version of this, the tiniest budget, where we're getting some random voice actor, we're not even getting an actual set of great dialogue and lines and plot. Why are you putting Peter Parker into this game if he's not really going to interact with the other Avengers? This is the laziest part of an already lazy game. But let's just take a look at this. Here's one thing that definitely is high quality. This is probably the best part of this DLC that's coming out. They're putting in some pretty awesome costumes. These are obviously different variations of, like, future Spider-Man. This is Peter Parker, where he's, like, the Daily Bugle costume when he was in a big hurry to take pictures and being Spider-Man. And, of course, things like the Iron Spider. This is awesome, but guess what? These are probably going to be, like, microtransactions. These are going to be sold skins. These are going to be things that come from the battle pass and stuff like that. Because clearly, they don't respect Peter Parker, and they don't respect Spider-Man's time. They just want to try and find another way to milk this freaking Marvel contract before they absolutely lose it. When this does actually come out, I do plan on beating it for myself and doing a review of this content, but the initial impressions, it feels like this is just the stupidest version of a character that deserves their entire great game. Look, I understand the fact that this is just an obligatory thing at this point. Spider-Man is exclusive to the PlayStation consoles. He is not allowed to exist on anything else. So I do understand that Square Enix, because they've already admitted that the Avengers game is a complete catastrophe and has lost them literally hundreds of millions of dollars, I completely understand that this is a low priority project. They're not going to spend tons and tons of cash specifically on Spider-Man if everything else has already just started to geyser cash out of their bank accounts. I still think that you could have done better than this. The fact that in this gameplay it looks like some of his punches don't even connect with targets feels like you are just not even attempting to half-ass it. This is some quarter-ass content. In fact, just yesterday, for funsies, I was playing some of the original PlayStation 1 version of Spider-Man. The way you connect hits on that, web swinging around on that, even this version of the game, as ancient as it is, this game was programmed 22 years ago, and in many aspects looks, plays, and is better than this DLC for Avengers, a project that's now on one of the most powerful gaming consoles. You guys screwed it up, and at this point, I don't think you even care. This is just them trying to ride the sinking ship off into the ocean. Why didn't you at least attempt to do something a little bit better? Give us some better intro cinematics. Give us a couple dedicated quests. The fact that he's probably just going to play in existing areas with his own little couple pieces of dialogue, this is the worst way to handle the best hero. And it shows not to trust Square Enix when it comes to the Avengers license. You guys screwed it up, and nobody is ever going to get you to trust them again. Like, this is just ridiculous. Okay, well, I wanted to yell about this because, honestly, I am very frustrated, and I feel like they're disrespecting my big, bad boy Spidey. What do you think about it, though? Is this as ridiculous to you as it is to me, or does this seem like just some tiny mess? I mean, let's face it, a lot of different companies like to try and force these stupid live service games, and all of them turn out to be completely undercooked brownie mix baked potato bullshit. Tell me your thoughts in the comments down below. If you enjoyed it, please give it a gigantic thumbs up, and if you could, please subscribe. But do me the biggest favor of all, and keep dreaming. God, Square Enix. You at least better have a good version of the Spider-Man theme song. You better be... Oh, you're not. I don't know. I have no hope. My desires have been dashed once again. Thanks so much for watching that video. If you want to see something else, you can always click this link to see what I put up last, or, you know, subscribe and see what's coming up next. Also, I promise that whatever I do, it'll try not to suck.